Need to write your dissertation but can't get started? I'm going to show you how right now. Hey everybody, I'm Lee Hall from teachingacademia.com and I'm all about giving you the tools you need to navigate academia and make your best impact. Today we're talking about how to start writing your dissertation. Now, you've already had the big picture overview and we've talked about how long it takes. And we've also talked about the order that I recommend that you write your dissertation in, okay? And when we talked about the order, I talked about, right, starting with methods so that you sort of get up and running and build this momentum. And that seemed like it answers the question of how to start writing your dissertation. And in part, it does, right? Because part of writing your dissertation, getting it started, is knowing where you're going to start. And at the very least, having a plan for I'm going to write my methods, and then I'm going to write my findings. And then as I said in a previous video about thinking about order, once you write methods and findings, you might have a little flexibility in terms of how you go about the rest of it. So when it's time to start, make a plan for the order that you think you would like to do things in. Figure out a schedule, okay? For how, when and how you want to write. But then most importantly, start writing, okay? So once you know that you're going to start writing your methods chapter, or once you know you're going to start writing your findings chapter, and you know what time you're going to show up, and you know how long you're going to spend on that, then you simply have to put your butt in the chair and spend the time putting the words on the page. And during this time, a key to getting started and building that momentum that I keep talking about is to not be overly critical of yourself. So one of the things that you have to realize as you start writing your dissertation, and this will hold true when you're writing a research paper as well, okay, or a book or anything, is that it's important to not be overly critical of yourself at first. You are getting the words and the ideas on the page, and you are probably, if you're lucky, doing a mediocre job at it, okay? But if you're like most of us, you're doing a really poor job of it. You're leaving out important pieces of information. You're wording things poorly, right? It's not super clear. You're not very concise. And you can see all of that as it's coming out in front of you. And it's easy to sort of think, oh, I need to stop. I need to go back. I need to fix this. This is not well written. Don't worry about that. Just get it out, okay? Get it out. Get it going. Build that momentum. You will have time to go back, obviously, and fix it. But what you don't want to do is have your inner critic so loud in your head that it prevents you from writing. Okay. So one of the big keys here in terms of getting yourself off the ground and running is knowing not just what you're going to write and when you're going to write, but knowing that you are simply going to write. Now, some days you will not write very much. So if you have, let's say, 2 hours blocked out, there have been times where at the end of 2 hours, I have paragraphs. They were extremely, extremely hard to write. It was like pulling teeth, right? And they are garbage paragraphs. And I know that they are going straight in the trash the next day when I sit down. Here's a little tip on that. You have to sit through that and write those garbage paragraphs and delete those garbage paragraphs in order to get to the good stuff, okay? So know that as you're starting, know that you're going to write a bunch of junk, know that you're going to write things that aren't very clear. You're also going to write some really good things, but writing and navigating through sort of like this crappy, junky, messy stuff, that is part of the process. So if you can let that go and accept that as you begin writing, you are going to have not necessarily a fun time all the time, but you will have a successful experience in writing your dissertation. And ultimately, that's what we're going for. So if you like this video and you want more, click right here, and I will see you over in the next one.